Well, welcome back, guys, to part three, and hopefully the final part of this 70-ton Volvo epic journey. This has been somewhat scattered with incidents, shall we say. Let's bring up the map, see where we are. If you remember, we came over through Calais on the ferry in the end, which turned out to be the better route than trying to take the train, which was an utter disaster. Looking down the journey here, there are some points to get slightly concerned about. There's a 90 degree left, which should be okay if I can use the whole road. Then it's fairly straightforward until we get to this here. Now, in part one, we saw what happened when I went around one of these things. However, this will be going down, so hopefully I can squeeze myself around there. We don't need to fuel up, we're just fueled, and then it's relatively straight until we get down to here. There's a curve there, that's not too bad. Straight down into Lyon, and at Lyon there's probably going to be some incident here involving trying to deliver this load into a courtyard I won't be able to do. So the actual final delivery could turn out to be a bit of a disaster. And after that, I've never been here, so I've got a couple of things to discover. And that will wrap the video up, but we shall see how this goes. Wish me luck. Right. Let's get started. If you look, I have to reconnect to the trailer now, because I couldn't go to sleep because I've got an extended load. So let's just pick up the Boabab tree of doom. There we go. And it's nearly 4 in the afternoon, so we should have a... Let's just get the track IR right here. There we go. That's where I want it. No, that's not where I want it. That's where I want it. For those of you asking, I keep getting asked the same questions. I use a Logitech joystick, and I can't use cruise control because I have a throttle paddle, an analog throttle paddle. All clear. So I know a lot of you guys replied on my first video telling me that the reason it reads zero on the dashboard is because that's the cruise control speed, so just press C for cruise control, but I can't use cruise control. And I have never driven the Volvos before, so I now understand what that zero means. So thank you for the comments. I now understand that. It feels like it's struggling up here. Not surprising, we have sustained about 5% engine damage or tractor damage at the moment. It's rather than a big power station. I've actually been to France, and I remember those power lines. The power line stands looking like that. They actually do look like that in a lot of France, and I think Germany has a very similar design from my memory. The British design of those power line, those things there, the British design of that is very different, and I've not seen the British design on mainland Europe. So I don't actually know, maybe you guys know, if there's another country in the world that uses the British design for that. Because I can't think of any reason why we need multiple designs apart from history, you know? Each country did its own thing. Essentially it has to do the same thing, it has to keep the lines separate with and have insulator blocks to stop the electricity conducting down the actual frame. So yeah, just a shape and height thing, I guess. But we seem to have a multitude of designs in that respect. Now, I am using the Realistic Physics 5. I used to use 1.7, and I believe 1.8 came out, but I had some issues with 1.8. And then I noticed there was a version 5. I believe 5 is written by a different author, but I'm not entirely sure. However, I have had no problems with version 5. Oh, crud. I didn't That's what you get for splitting the video. 1.5 hours to rest. Okay, we've got another problem on our hands. I need to find a rest stop, which is going to be interesting. Bugger. It's the word that comes to mind. There isn't even one. Oh, I don't fancy parking on. I might have to go into Paris. I might have to go straight down and drive into Paris and pick up a rest stop and then possibly head out that way. which might work out better anyway. So let's do that. Let's aim to go straight on. Hopefully I'll remember not to make the turn, and I'll go straight down into Paris and try and get some rest. And I've forgotten what I was talking about now. I often do that. I jump subjects and totally forget what I was talking about. Oh, realistic physics. That was it. Let's slow down here because this looks awfully bumpy. Yeah, I had a feeling that was going to happen. As soon as I saw it, I thought, I'm in trouble. I didn't slow down enough. One tip you guys said, remember when I was trying to do an emergency stop and I was about to go into the back of a car that had just randomly decided to stop and I swerved around it in the end, and one of you guys said, put on the emergency brake. Put on the parking brake and you'll get a lot more braking force, which is an interesting solution which I hadn't thought of. So again, thank you for the tip, and I am just sharing that in case you guys didn't read that actual comment. So yeah, what he's saying is obviously put on the brakes and then apply the parking brake, which gives you more braking force. Sounds like a good tip to me. I just have to remember to do it when those situations arise. So yeah, I'm using Realistic Physics 5, and I've not really had a problem with it. It's been working quite well. I did have the reversing bug in one of my previous videos, and a lot of people have suffered the reversing bug, and that's come about from the Agorabatic trailer mod as well, and not working properly with Realistic Physics. Now, I have removed the Agorabatic trailer mod, but it did dig its dirty little paws into my save game file, and as a result, when I got rid of it, it somehow corrupted the save game, and I lost 100,000 pounds out of the game. In fact, at one point it was losing me levels as well, so that wasn't fun at all. Now this is where I'm meant to make the left turn, and I'm going to go straight on down to Paris. So if you are using that Agorabatic mod, then if you want to get rid of it, I suggest you save your game first, then get rid of it and check your level and cash after you've removed it to see if it's the same. Most likely you will have lost something, but I'm not going to reinstall that mod because it does mess up your save games, and I didn't realise that until it was far too late. So apologies if you use that because of me and it does mess up your save game, but I genuinely didn't know. I do try my best not to tell you about mods that mess things up, but that one slipped through the net, so I do apologise for that. You can continue to use it, and it does appear to work with Realistic Physics 5 okay, so yeah, try that. But don't forget, Realistic Physics, always load it last, and you do that by putting Z's on the front of the file name. That's the best way. Okay, we're coming on the approach into Paris. Obviously getting very twisty. I'm just taking my time here because this is, it's pretty twisty. One of you guys have asked me, I don't know if all of you want me to do this or not, but you've asked me to put back that mirror while I'm running the wide load. I'm not exactly sure why. It's just saved me looking over there, obviously. But I don't know. I need your opinion on this one. I'm quite happy to run without the mirror and just look over. Obviously you can see the left mirrors. Yes, I know I'm tired. But do you want me to run with that mirror or not? Please leave me your comments. I'll run with it for this part 3, but I do need some feedback on that. And if you do leave comments on the video with that, then hopefully I'll get to read it. I do try to read all of your comments. Oh, look at the trailer clipping. I'm going to run the whole carriageway on this one, screw them. But I do need feedback. Facebook page is the best way to give me feedback. Just send me a message with what you think. Or you can, of course, email me if you so choose. But comments, I tend to get a lot of comments and things do get lost. Now then, the rest stop is, let me just double check this map because I really don't want to go the wrong direction here. The rest stop looks like, should I take a right there or do I go straight on that? Might go straight over the top. So there's a rest stop there as well at the service center. I could get my truck repaired, couldn't I? Yeah, let's do that. Let's make a double left and detach the trailer, rest, and pick up a repair. And then I want to check what the delivery time is on this, because I need to know when I need to get this thing in. So here we are in Paris. Now, where's the Eiffel Tower? That's what I'm thinking. I don't see the Eiffel Tower. I would have thought that was a pretty iconic building. Let's have a look around. Oh, there it is. Is that it? Yes, I think that's it, just to the right. Do we agree that's the Eiffel Tower? Yeah, on the horizon, that's it. Not a very detailed one, mind, but it is there, so I'll let them off for that. Okay. Some of you guys have pointed out that I should have put beacons on this thing and run with beacons on a wide load. That one did slip my mind. Oh, look, the cement mixer! It needs turning! Sorry, guys, I'm going to have to look. Look! It does actually turn. I know, just bugging up all the traffic, but... Oh, crud. Uh-oh. Do you foresee a problem here? I foresee a problem. That's what you get for stopping and having a look at the scenery. Let's see if I can cut this guy up without damaging... No. Bugger! Oh, of course. Of course, he's just come here. I'm going to have to ride over this guy. Sorry, dude. No, I can't move. He's actually got trapped. Why is it these things never go smoothly? Let's take a run up. No, I haven't got the power. Oh no, I've got beached again. Okay. It's bloody physics. Right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to detach the trailer. Move the truck out the way. There we go. And I'm going to reattach the trailer. Hopefully. Hopefully that'll fix it. No, that's not fixing it. I can't look at the wheel spinning. I can't bloody move. Right, I'll tell you what I'm going to do, I think, is... How do we call for the... I'm trying to remember how you call for help. I've never actually called for help. I think once I might have called for assistance. Which is going to put me in the nearest garage, which is there, funnily enough. Oh, there we go, F7... F7? Do you want to cancel your current job? No! Hell no! What I want to do is call for help with F7, and F7's not working. Why are you no work? F1 to pause, yeah. Okay, I'm unable to call for assistance for some reason. Right, I'm gonna cheat. Watch this. Look at the traffic. Oh, shit. I'm going to leave the trailer there. Of course, they're not going to move now, are they? Whoa, look at that! This guy just drove straight through my trailer! Epic! Right, I'm going to drive off. And I'm going to come... Whoops, wrong keys. My apologies. I know you paused. I'm going to drive round. Sorry, I'm pressing all the wrong buttons here. That's what I wanted. F5. I'm going to drive over here, and then I'm going to turn around and come back. And magically, I'm thinking the game's going to clear the mess up. So look at the map. I want to go back there. So I'm going to do a right turn and head back that way. Yeah. I'm thinking, let's go back round. And I reckon all of that traffic situation will have sorted itself out, and I'll be sat there with a trailer that can reattach to and take it into the service centre. The other thing I could do is just go to the service centre, rest, repair, and leave my trailer in the road. But that feels ridiculous. I mean, I know I can do it, but that just feels ridiculous. So I'm going to try and do this a slightly sensible way, given that those cars won't move out the way. I'm thinking if I loop round, they'll go back and they'll despawn. And I can get the damn trailer out the way. Because frankly, in a real world scenario, I don't think that would really happen. And if it did happen, you could just get out the car and say, "Oi, move your car." Look, there's the bloody trailer again. Bastards. Of course, I'm seeing them all the time now. Oh, look, that theory got blown out the water. Shit. What's the holdup, guys? What's happened? Oh, shit, look at this mess. Oh, bollocks. I can't even get to the car. To the trailer. I can't get past. Oh, I've caused such a nightmare problem. Right, I've got... Okay, cunning plan number two is to go back round. I can't even get on the pavement. If I could get on the... I know. I have a cunning plan, says Baldrick. Yes, I know, I'm getting tired. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back round. I'm going to try and get on the pavement to get into the garage where I can rest and hopefully wake up to a wonderfully empty junction. But obviously, with this game, you never know what's going to happen next. Obeying all traffic laws purely to try and not get fined a large amount of money. Have you noticed the headlights doing weird things? Like all of the headlights are on permanently. That's to do with the heavy traffic mod, which was supposed to adjust the headlights. Actually, that van, I was about to say that van didn't have any traffic lights on. Look at the detail on the vehicles changing as they approach. But I don't mind having the lights on all the time. That's not my concern. The problem I have is that the lights seem to shoot out at very strange angles on the cars, which is kind of odd. I don't know if this is what I would call... Oh, there we go, sleeping offences coming in. I don't know if this is... At least are my problems, to be honest. I don't know if this is what I would call heavy traffic. This heavy traffic AI mod doesn't feel like it's particularly heavy. Here we go. Right, let's try and get on the curb. This will probably go horribly wrong as well. Squeeze through the gap. Breaking all traffic laws right now. There you go, and I made it into the dealer. Which dealer is it, by the way? Maybe all that traffic will have buggered off. Oh, this delivery is just not without its problems. Nothing's going smoothly, honestly. Not F4, we want F6. Right, I've got... Okay, it's Friday, 3 a.m. It's got to be there at 9 a.m. I don't have time to... I've got to drive through the night. I don't have a choice. Let's go and get my trailer quickly. I was wondering if I could go to sleep again in order to be able to drive in the day rather than drive at night. Now, I'm looking at my trailer and I'm a bit worried because it appears to be sunk into the... Oh. There's always one, isn't there? There's always one. My trailer appears to be sunk into the floor, so I'm not entirely certain that I'm going to be able to pick this thing up. But we shall see. This looks properly messed up right now. Please work. I can't pick my trailer up, guys. Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. I'm pressing T and nothing's happening. It's broken. I've broken the game. I've broken the game. I can't get my trailer. I'm just reversing into my trailer. There's no pickup point. It's fallen through the floor. Who knows? Hmm. I'm going to have to reload it. I'm going to have to go further back. Darn it. Okay. Time to reload. Right. We are back, guys. And I have to say, that was interesting. I'm not going to get distracted by shiny concrete mixers. I had to load it back in. That distraction caused an awful lot of problems. I couldn't have anticipated that, but good grief. So here we are. The intended destination. Which I'm going to go and get a rest first in case I get a fine. So I'm going to park over here. Actually, why don't I just detach the trailer here. And move forward and get some rest. Like that. And hopefully that won't sink into the ground. If it does, I'll be very annoyed. Sleepy, sleepy. Wake up. And the trailer's not in the ground, which is always a good start. Now, let's go and check out the repair bill, shall we? It is the night time, of course. Which is slightly unfortunate. But I think if I check, I'll check the delivery schedule in a minute to see if I can get away with another rest or not. Right. Service. 8,000 for a service. I'm actually amazed. I thought I'd done so much more front end damage to this vehicle. Surely it should be more than that. 6% to the actual chassis. 2% to the transmission. 3% to the engine. I thought it was a lot more. I thought I'd, you know, it's more like in the 10, 15, 20% mark. Okay, well, I'll trust the French mechanics to sort me out. Actually, while we're here, for the last bit of this journey, although I haven't got the cash, I'm going to do it anyway. I'm going to please you guys, and I really hope you appreciate this. Let's get the cheapest one, actually. I hope you appreciate this. I'm going to put your beacons on the... just to be all proper. Let's get some of these lights going as well so we can see where we're going. How much is that? 5.5 grand. What the hell? What the hell, he says. Let's get the lights on. Let's get the beacons on. Should I put the beacons on? No, I didn't put the beaters on. Oh, sorry. Not derp. Front roof auxiliary is what we want. Are they on? Really? That's not very bright. Maybe I just need to put high beams on. Oh well, that'll do. That's enough to annoy everybody on the road. Let's keep pressing T until it does it. Come on, game. Come on, you can do it. Don't be afraid. There we go. Whew. I actually thought for a minute I wasn't going to be able to pick my trailer up. I was about to sit in a corner and cry for a while. Okay. Let's try and get out of here safely. Without trashing anything else in this company's car park. Is this a Iveco dealer? I think it's an Iveco dealer. Can't really see the back. Let's try that. Let's make the turn. No, it's not having that. A bit more. Okay, maybe that'll do it. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. Maybe you can't. Oh, that was close. Oh, that was so close. You can wait. Right, let's get this trailer on the road, shall we? Wow. This is... oh, I'm stuck again. What am I stuck on now? Oh no! Right, I'm going to have to move out of the way. Wow, I didn't anticipate that. I'll let him go. You know what? Sod it. I'm going to go this way. I'm going to go... I'm not even going to try and cut that bend. We shall go this way and deliver this bloody lump of wood. Okay, what's the easiest way? I'm thinking, let's make a... Let's go this way. So I want to make a right turn, then another right turn. That should get me back where I want to go. I don't know if you're tempted or not to try this trailer, but wow. This has probably been one of the funniest experiences and most difficult experiences I've had in Euro Truck. To say it's up in the hard scale is an understatement. Oh, stop! How close was that? Oh, that's fine. You can't get used to the weight of these things. It's just unbelievable how much stopping power you suddenly don't have. I've got beacons. You shouldn't even be going anywhere near me, if you've got any sense. No excuses now, have they? I mean, the beacons are running, so... According to this, I want to go straight on. I'm going to ignore that advice. And make a sharp right. Keeping as far to the outside as I possibly can. And I go around this roundabout. Actually, I heard that in America, you don't... have many roundabouts, and when you call them rotaries, but you don't have that many. Is there a reason for that? Is there a reason why you don't have roundabouts? Oh mate, come on, it's just, I've got beacons on, I've got a 58 ton load and you just pull out. You just got a suicide pact. Yeah, I'm curious as to why. If that's true, if Americans don't have roundabouts, I'm curious as to why, actually. Because they're actually very useful, and I see them all over Europe. And they beat having traffic lights, that's for sure. The traffic lights are a bloody pain, quite frankly. He says, slowing down in case it goes to red, which it does. Stop! There we go. Parking brake on. You watch me forget to turn that off. Well, the Volvo's fully repaired now. Look at the beacons reflecting on the wood, that looks pretty cool. The Volvo is fully repaired. Oh yes, that's the other thing. Some people were asking, it's always forget. Some people were asking about the 820 brake horsepower engine. And where does that come from? Because it's not available in the standard game. That's very true, and not only is it not available in the standard game, the 820 brake horsepower for the Volvo FH16, but in real life, you can't get the 820 brake horsepower engine for the FH16, because I looked it up on their website. Basically, that engine seems to come from the Realistic 5 mod, bizarrely. I'm not entirely sure why. I didn't realise it was going to do that. But yeah, this brings me back to what I always say about to mod authors. If you're going to write a mod, write them small, specifically focused on doing one thing really well, and then include a readme that tells everyone what the mod does and what it doesn't do. I see so many mods that have side effects, so many mods that, you know, you'll get a trailer pack. And it'll have a speed limiter in it. I thought, what? Hello? You know, why are you doing that? Just make your trailer pack. Make it focus. Because I want to mix and match my mods, so I don't want to have mods that are clashing left, right, and centre. Look at that. Katarina, 6.5 grand. That's nice. That just paid for those beacons and lights. So yeah, if you're going to write a mod, make it focused. And if you want to write a speed limiter or a speed limiter, do it in a separate mod. Don't bundle things together. It makes them so hard for people like me who want to use mods to pick and choose what we want to use. And it also just increases the chance of a clash, quite frankly. That's a little rant out the way. But it's true. I mean, the physics mod, why does it include an extended engine? I didn't know that. Georgia, 6,600, just trumped Katarina with the cash there. Let's go to back up to 80 grand. Apart from the speeding fines I've had, I've repaired the truck, which means as long as I don't deliver this thing late, I shall get... How much is the job? 21 grand. Oh, that is so disappointing. 21 grand. That's all I'm getting. I feel like I've worked my nuts off for this. Excuse the pun. Oh, it's a... Here we go. Here we go. It's the toll road of doom. Toll roads of doom. Stop. 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 Parking brake. Stop. Oh, my God. Right, I'm going to go backwards. I hope there's nobody behind me. Right. Stop. Okay. What am I doing, he says. Detaching trailer. Going forward to pay my toll fee. Going back for my trailer. Got it. Okay, so the reason I do this is because it's so hard to pull and it's a long load. I want to pick up speed and hopefully get through it before that barrier comes down. Well, that worked a bloody treat, didn't it? Thank you, game. Thank you so much. What on... Oh, I've got an engine. It's just wrecked my truck. I'm 100% broken. Look at that. Look at the fucking game. I can't move. Oh my God. This game gets better and better. This is the disaster video to end all disaster videos. But I'm not paying that. I'm not paying that repair bill. I'm going to have to load the game back in again. This game's trolling me. This load does not want to be delivered. It is fighting me to death. I am determined to deliver this bloody tree now.